At Digital A YouTube channel, Python tutorials. My name is Srinivas. In this video, I'm going to discuss about read function in Python. Now, mainly, this function is used in file operations. This is a built-in function. Is a built-in function. This function is used to handle the files. Okay, clear. Now, second one. This read function is used to read the text data or some CSV files data. Read the data from the given file, the main purpose of the read function is read the data from the given file by using the R mode. Now in Python the read function is available. In Python, the read function is available four forms. One form is only read. The second form is read in the brackets parenthesis n. What is n? The third form is read line. Fourth one is read lines. Four different types of read functions are available in Python. Now the first one is what is read function. This function read the entire data. This function reads the entire data from the given file. Okay, another syntax is simply only read, no arguments, no need of any arguments. Right, for example, read the entire data. Example one, to read the entire data from a file. How to read the file? First step, to open a file. How to open a file? Open a file by using the open inbuilt function. Open the file name is sample.txt. Okay, clear, guys. First of all, file name is sample.txt. Name of the file. Open function, two arguments. One argument is file name. The second argument is mode, which purpose you have to open the file. The file, now we are opening, the purpose is read mode. Open. That the value is assigned to an object. Object equal to file pointer. Now the file pointer equal to open. But to open a file, purpose is reading purpose only. Now here, if you want to read the entire data, here we are using the entire data. Now after reading, the data is assigned to some variable. Now to read, file pointer dot read, simply object name dot read without any argument. The entire data is assigned to data variable, or entire data is assigned to x variable. Some x, it is a variable. The entire data is assigned to d variable, d for data, and assigned to d variable. After that, after assigning, simply print the data. That's all. There are only three steps only. Step one, open a file. Open the entire data, to read the entire data. So open a file. Second step is to read the entire data. Here, open a file. Here the comment line, to open a file R mode. To open a file R mode, clear, first step. And the second step is read entire data. Is the comments, into the comments, read total data. This data means d is a variable, and the entire file data is assigned to d variable, and after completing the total information. Now here, for example, if you want to store, read some message. Okay, the sample.txt file content is, you want to show this value, sample.txt file, the content is, this is the data for d. Here the entire remaining theory part enclosed in the comment section. Now the enclosed by triple quote. This is open for only for read function. Now run this module. sample.txt is an existing file to store some data. Now run this file. Now read the entire data from the file. Okay, now this is a sample.txt file content. The content of the sample.txt file. The sample.txt file content is, this is, the sample.txt content is, the sample.txt content is only Python is a high level programming language. C is a compiler programming language. CPP is mainly used for the games, Java and data. So this is the content of the sample.txt file. For example, you have to open the file, sample.txt file. To open a file, sample.txt file. This is the content. This is the sample.txt file. It is a file. The entire content is read and print the given prompt. Clear, guys? This is mainly used for read function. Now the next function is the second function is readN function. ReadN. That means what is N? ReadN function. This function is used to read the n characters only. Read the n characters only. Only n characters are reading. Not the entire data. Read only n characters. N means any number. The syntax is read of n. N is size. Read of n. Here n is size. That's all. Okay. Now, for example, in this function, read the entire data. But here, for example, if you want to read the specific data, find read of n. N means any number. To read only is the function to read first three characters. Three means size. This is the size for only for three characters. Open up sample.txt file, the value assigned to FP, file pointer read only without any arguments, read the entire data. Three are with only number three. Three means read. Three characters only. Read three characters only. Clear? Observe this one. Read three characters only. That's all. Read the three characters only. Sample.txt file content is, so remember only for D. Now the D is assigned only three characters. Now what is three? This is a sample.txt file. In this file, first three characters means PYT. This function, this program returns only first three characters only. Please observe this one. Only three characters. Now the first character. Here the entire file. The first one to read the entire file. And the second one to read only first three characters. For example, we want to read the value is n. For example, if you want to read the value equal to, for example, 5. For example, 5. Read only first 5 characters. Right? And the first example, read the 3 characters. And the second one example, read the 5 characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 characters. If you want to read the first 8 characters, read the value, first 3 characters. 8 characters only. 6 characters. Including blank space is also a character. Again, 8 characters. Clear, guys? Up to here, all of you. Okay. Now the next one, the next third one. Read line. Third function is read line function. This function is used to read. Only one line. Okay, syntax is read line. That's all. Without any arguments, this function is used to read only one line at a time. Now, you want to read one line at a time. Okay, example. To read first line. Read first line only. Now here to read only first line. So first open a file. File pointer equal to open up file name. The file name is sample.txt. Any name and opening mode is read mode. Clear. Now to read only first line. That's why fp.read line only first line. That is stored in that is stored in the R A, some A, no problem, A value, and print of A. Print of A, that's all. Print only one line, print only one line. You need only first line. Run this module. Okay. Here, the first line is Python is a high level programming language. This is the first line. Python is high level programming language. This is the first line. Read only this line. Okay. Read only this line. Okay. Python is a high level programming. Only one line is reading it at a time. Only one line. If you want to read first three lines, if you want to read first three lines, now we are using, if you want to read first three lines. This is example, only first line. Example, if you want to read only first three lines, if you want to read first three lines. Another example, example two, this is second example, if you want to read the first three lines. Okay, the first three lines. So now you have to read the first line. First line assigned to you. And read the second line. First start, read out, read line, second line. C equal to file pointer dot read line. This is the third line. First line is assigned to A. Second line is assigned to B. Third line is assigned to C. And print to first line. Print of B, second line. And print of C. Now we have to print only three lines. And after that, file close the file. Now read the file. Read the file. First line, Python is a high-level programming language. Second line, C is a compiler based. Fourth line, C is mainly used. So now open the file, sample.txt, and observe the content. First line, second line, and third line. Clear, guys? Now go to the next statement. The next one is to read the next one is third one, the last fourth one, read lines. Very important function. This function is used to read all lines from a given file. But return value is a list type. Okay, this function returns the result as a list type. As a list type. Clear, guys? The output is completely list type. Now, example. To read all data. To read entire data. Okay. From a file. Now both are similar. Observe this one. First one, read the entire data. But only for cache. Here that read the entire data. The output returns as a list type. Please observe this one. Now we are writing. Okay, now we are using, but the answer is only list type. Okay, first of all, open your file. File pointer equal to open up file name sample.txt file. Okay, and purpose is only for reading purpose. File pointer dot read lines of read lines. The data is assigned to D equal to and print of D. And file pointer dot close. File pointer dot close. Clear. Now B is a variable, but indirectly this variable has a list type. The entire data, return the data as a list type. Run this one. Okay, this is data. The previous example, return the data as the entire data, the entire content to be displayed. Here, but the content is displayed as a list type, because it's enclosed in the square bracket. Square bracket in Python, the list variables are assigned as a list type. For example, you want to see the result and print of type of B. Type of B means B as a list type. Please observe this one. B variable. This data, this function reads the entire data from the file and the value is assigned to D. Now D is a list type. For example, if you want to print this one, for example, one line by line for I in D. Print of I, line by line. If you want to print the line by line, use this for loop for the purpose. So this is the entire D value printed, but if you want to print the line by line using for loop in lists, same concept here. Clear, guys? Okay, this is the read function in Python. Okay, please observe this one. In Python, the read function is available in the different formats. This function is mainly used for the read the data from the file This is available in the four different formats: read, read n, read line, and read lines. Okay, guys, up to here, clear all of you? All these functions are used to read the values from the files based on the different purposes. Guys, clear? Thank you very much. Thanks for watching this video.